Hello, I'm Professor John Kelly, and this is the Weber Auto YouTube channel. The thing I want to talk about is the thermal management of these batteries. Both the Bolt EV battery and the Volt batteries are liquid cooled and liquid heated, and have been on the Volt since 2011 when it came out, and on the Bolt here in 2017 and above. And if the Bolt battery life is it going to be anything like the Chevrolet Volt battery life, it's going to be very good, because those 2011 and above Chevrolet Volts with the liquid heating and liquid cooling to keep them in their preferred temperature range always, even when the vehicle's off, seems to be keeping those batteries in really good shape, and their electric vehicle range is still very close to what it was when it was new. I had great hopes that the 2018 Nissan Leaf would be much improved, and in my opinion, it's not. The Nissan Leaf 2018 is not a liquid-cooled or heated battery. It's just cooled by whatever temperature the air is inside the passenger compartment. So if you have your air conditioning running, then the battery gets cooled by the cool air running through the air condition or through your passenger compartment. If it's cold outside and you have the heater running, then the hot air in your passenger compartment helps heat the battery, but there's also a battery heater. But the thing that really struck me as funny about the new Nissan Leaf is in the owner's manual. For you Nissan Leaf lovers or anybody investigating buying the new Leaf, take a look at page EV20 of the owner's manual. You can download it for free on Nissan's website. So page EV-20. It has a big section on lithium-ion battery life. And I'm not going to read the whole thing, but there are certain things in here that are temperature-related that affect battery life. So let me read you just kind of the introduction here. The lithium-ion battery's ability to hold a charge can be affected by how you drive the vehicle, store the vehicle, and how you charge the lithium-ion battery, and lithium-ion battery temperature during vehicle operation and charging. And then it says, to maximize the battery's useful life, use the following driving and charging habits where possible. And there's a bunch of these, but I'm only going to read you the ones that are temperature related. So the first one reads, avoid exposing a vehicle to extreme ambient temperatures for extended periods. So if you live in a hot climate, you're out of luck. Avoid storing the vehicle in temperatures below negative 25 degrees Celsius for more than 7 days. All right, the next thing, and this one's kind of humorous, is allow the vehicle and lithium-ion battery to cool down after use before charging. So I interpret that to mean you can't just drive home, park your vehicle and plug in the charger and forget about it until the next day when you need to leave again, which you can do with the Chevrolet Bolt EV and the Volt. Done it for years. I've had Chevrolet Volts since 2011. All right, the next thing, park and store your vehicle in cool locations out of direct sunlight and away from heat sources. The next thing, avoid sustained high battery temperatures caused, for example, by exposure to high ambient temperatures or extended highway driving with multiple quick charges, if so equipped with the quick charger. So if you want to go on a long drive cross country and you're going to use the quick charger option, it says don't do that without letting it cool down in between. So there you got to extend your drive even longer with this silly thermal management of a battery system they have. The next thing, which is even funnier, use the normal charge or trickle charging methods to charge the lithium-ion battery and minimize the use of public fast charge or quick charger. Like, why buy the quick charge option if they don't want you to use it? Because it's going to minimize your battery life. And then do a lot of moderate driving and use the eco mode a lot. All right, so here's the owner's manual section for the Chevrolet Bolt EV 2017. I couldn't find any section called lithium-ion battery life like the Nissan Leaf has. But the only section I found in the Bolt EV that even related to the battery was a section called plug-in charging. And this section just has two things I want to read to you that are interesting. Number one, this section explains the process for charging the high-voltage battery. So it just has two suggestions here. Do not allow the vehicle to remain in temperature extremes for long periods without being driven or plugged in. Now, they don't define temperature extremes, but I interpret that to mean really hot temperatures or really cold temperatures. And then it sort of defines it a little bit here. It says, it is recommended that the vehicle be plugged in when temperatures are below 32 degrees Fahrenheit, 0 Celsius, and above 90 degrees Fahrenheit or 32 degrees Celsius to maximize high voltage battery life. Okay, so that's somewhat similar to the Nissan Leaf. But what they're telling you is keep it plugged in when it's hot like that or cold like that, or drive it occasionally so that the thermal management system, the liquid cooled system, can keep it in the proper temperature. If it's hot outside and you've got your vehicle plugged in, so what? Anyone with a Chevrolet Volt or Bolt can tell you that while it's plugged in, there's cooling fans running, the air conditioning compressor runs to cool the liquid going through the battery while it's hot. If it's really cold, the battery coolant heater will turn on and keep it warmed up to a certain point. So my point is, the Chevrolet Bolt EV and Volt battery temperature or thermal management system is far superior, and these batteries are going to last a very long time. Thank you for watching, and have a good day.